Thank you very much, Minister. Thank you for coming to the House this morning. I think this is the first time I addressed you since your elevation, so congratulations on that. Minister, I've been asked to raise this matter today by Councillor Ben Brennan from Laois, but I know that the matter will interest quite a number of people around the country. Specifically, what we're talking about is community employment schemes and those who reach the late 50s, early 60s that are on them. Since the CE schemes were first introduced, they've delivered a number of objectives for individuals and communities. They've served as both activation and social inclusion measures and have been adapted to times of low and high unemployment. The schemes are the backbone of many local services in areas such as childcare, health and social care, outdoor works and local facilities. Workers on the schemes work hand in glove with many local organisations, including Tidy Towns and local authorities. It was widely reported at the height of the pandemic that CE workers were the first to step up to the call to support older people who were cocooned in their homes by providing Meals on Wheels and other services funded by the HSE. Participants on schemes are normally long-term unemployed or from targeted social inclusion groups such as those who are parenting alone or have a disability. There's no doubt that the schemes have been very successful in delivering on both activation and social inclusion objectives. One of the features of the scheme is that they extend across the life cycle, and Fine Gael governments in the past in particular have been very responsive to lowering and increasing the qualifying age. I know that in 2019 the general qualifying age for CE scheme was reduced from 25 to 21 years, and for those over 55 the age allowed them to remain on a CE scheme for 3 years. Minister, we've been very realistic about the activation outcome from the schemes. It is a lot more likely that a young person will go on to full-time employment than someone in their late 50s or 60s. This is not because of any reluctance on the part of the older cohort. The jobs just aren't there, and while many might not like to admit it, there is ageism when it comes to hiring workers, and it's rampant. We now have a situation where very talented older participants on CE schemes have to effectively leave work on the scheme well ahead of retirement age, leaving them in an unemployed limbo for up to 4 years. There is plenty of anecdotal evidence that many older workers on CE schemes are making no extra money at all. All they're spending the €20 they get on the scheme on petrol and sandwiches during the week. However, they love to go to work. They love the energy and commitment that's required when you're on these schemes. Older participants are valuable mentors for younger participants and have a lifetime of rich knowledge and experience to share. I believe that it behoves us to ring-fence this group, to protect the opportunity for participation and to ensure that if they want, that they can stay on the scheme right up to retirement age. Just to conclude, Minister, I believe that the Fine Gael party in government has always been very proactive and responsive to changing labour market demands and the needs of CE scheme participants. I'm very hopeful that you will respond to the call to extend the participation age up to retirement age. Councillor Brennan, when he contacted me, was deeply distressed about a 62-year-old man who, because he has reached the full limit on the scheme, he's now being expected to go on the dole and do nothing. And the only cost to the state of keeping him on the scheme was €20. I just think it's wrong in every sense of the word. So I look forward to your response, Minister.
Margaret, community employment is the largest employment and training programme administered by the Department of Social Protection. The CE programme was initially established under the aegis of FOSS to enhance the employability of long-term unemployed people by providing work experience and training opportunities for them within their communities. Its objective continues to be to provide valuable work experience for long-term unemployed people and help prepare them to gain employment. The CE programme is delivered throughout the community and voluntary sector by independent CE sponsoring authorities. In general, CE placements for new entrants aged between 21 and 55 years are for 1 year. CE participants who are working towards a QQI major award can seek to extend their participation on CE by up to 2 years to enable them to reach the required standard of qualification. A significant number of CE participants each year avail of an extension in order to continue training and obtain qualifications or major awards. However, CEE participants aged 55 years or older can remain on CEE for 3 years and do not have to work towards a QQI major award. In either scenario, a maximum of 3 consecutive years participation on CEE is permissible. A person may re-qualify for CEE after a 12-month break once they satisfy the qualifying conditions. An overall lifetime limit of 6 years applies to all CEE participants, 7 years for those on a disability payment. Now, a pilot initiative known as Service Support Stream was implemented in January 2016 for those aged 62 or older. The initiative facilitated up to 7% of the total CEE participant numbers being allowed to extend their participation beyond the maximum duration normally permitted and to remain on CEE up to the state pension age, provided the participant continued to meet the eligibility conditions and the number of places on the CEE scheme was not exceeded. Overall, the service support stream was positively received by CEE sponsoring authorities and the CEE participants who availed of this pilot scheme. Now, a number of new conditions were introduced on CEE in July 2017 to further support progression and to broaden access to CEE for a wider range of people. The service support stream was one of the new options provided on a more mainstream basis, and in 2018, the 7% limit for service stream support participation placements was increased to enable 10% of the total number of CEE participants to apply for this facility for those over 62 years of age and without the need to have a 12-month break in their previous CEE participation, provided the participant continued to meet the eligibility conditions and the number of places on the CEE scheme was not exceeded. Therefore, in summary, I can confirm to the Centre that CEE participants over the age of 62 can continue on a continuous basis up to the state pension age on this specific CEE service support scheme strand. This is subject to the standard criteria such as availability of places on the service support stream, satisfactory performance on the CEE scheme, and annual approval by the department. Thank you.
Thank you very much for that response, Minister. I appreciate it. Look, Minister, the CEE schemes have been the poor relation. When I look at the way the supervisors on the schemes have been treated down through the years, and I know that you were not there to oversee that. At the end of the day, I visited a CEE scheme in Wexford during the summer, and it was amazing to see these men in their late 50s and 60s really committed to the work they were doing in a garden down in Wexford. And I think we need to waive all restrictions for somebody that's over 62. If they're on the CEE scheme and the sponsor and the supervisor are happy with the work they are doing, they should be allowed to remain there until retirement age with no restrictions and no qualifying criteria. And I would ask you to bring that back to the department, Minister, because I think there's nothing worse for mental health than being forced onto unemployment. My colleague spoke a few moments ago about the devastating effects of unemployment, and I've been there myself. I know what it's like. So if you would bring that back to the department. And the other issue, we really need to look after the supervisors with respect to pension entitlements and the like. So thank you very much for being here today, Minister, and I appreciate your answer.
Some further information that might be of use as well is that nationally there are about 19,000 places for CEE schemes, so 10% are under the service support stream. And at the moment, it's undersubscribed nationally, so 1,081 CEE participants availing of the service support stream at present. Now, that 10% limit was previously at the provider's level, at a local level. We have bumped that up now to divisional level, which should give more flexibility to local providers to go beyond the 10% to some extent in some situations. But that will vary from place to place at a very local level. And I think just to acknowledge as well that a lot of the people availing of the service support stream also contribute invaluable advice and guidance to other newer and less experienced CEE participants as well over the course of their work and activities. Thank you.